Hey guys, this is Al with ZZPerformance. Today we're going to do a quick video on how to do the timing chain on LSJ. It sounds way more intimidating than it is. I have a lot of people ask questions about how to do it, and they get worried about doing it themselves, that they're going to time it wrong or install the tensioner wrong. I myself am a visual learner, so I thought this would be a good way to get this on video. The way you guys can look at it, rewind it, go back and forth, do whatever you need to do. It's a lot easier for us to show it to you on the engine stand. Obviously, you're probably going to be doing it in the car. This can be done after you replace the head gasket, installed a ported head, or even just swapping your cams out. All of the Ecotec timing chains, even from the aftermarkets, will have three colored links on the chain. And whatever the odd colored link is the one that will go with the intake cam on the front of the motor. Now, before you take your chain off, if you're doing cam swap or a head swap or anything, you're going to save yourself a lot of headache if you set the engine at top dead center on the cylinder 4 compression stroke before you take anything apart. The easiest way for you to do that is have your valve cover off and rotate the engine forward until your cam gears are sitting like this. You'll see there's a mark on the cam gear that says INT, that's for intake, and it'll be about the 2 o'clock position. And your exhaust cam says EXH for exhaust, and that will be sitting about the 10 o'clock position. All right, so when you have the engine sitting top dead center with the cylinder 4 on the compression stroke, your keyway on the crankshaft is going to be at the top, and just off to the side here, there's a little dot on the crank key sprocket. This is going to go with one of your colored links. You hold this tight, come up to the top and take your intake cam and line up your intake mark with the odd colored mark. On this particular chain, it's a dark green one. Now there's a key inside of the cam gear and a slot on the end of the cam. You'll use a 15/16 wrench to wiggle the cam back and forth until you get the cam gear teeth to slide into the slot. Once you get that in, you snug a bolt in, so hold her in place. You move over to your exhaust cam, and you have your remaining colored link. Line it up with the exhaust mark on the cam gear, and then you do the same thing with your 15/16 wrench and move the cam gear until you get the keyway to line up, or move the cam rather. And you'll feel it pop in. Before anything else happens, throw your bolt in there snug. Before you go any farther, go through and double check every single gear and make sure that your marks are on the appropriate links. So we'll come down here and double check. We have one of the purple links on the cam or the crank gear dot. We have the off colored link on the intake and the remaining colored link on the exhaust. Now comes the time to put your chain tensioner back in. This is an old style one since this is just our mock-up motor, but they all function the same internally. There is a spring inside. There's a ratchet mechanism in here so that even when there's no oil pressure, the tensioner can only compress so far. Now when you get the tensioner out of the box, it will be compressed all the way. If I can even do it now. There. Just for demonstration purposes, a lot of times you receive them and the end will float because that ratchet is locked in place. My preferred way of installing a tensioner is to take this and just push the end of it in to release that ratchet. Now the plunger is tight and it won't go in all the way. So on the back side of the motor, you'll put this in. Sometimes you have to give it a little bit of a squeeze to get the threads to start, which this can be a pain in the butt while the engine is in the car, but trust me, you can do it. Once you get things started, run her in. And it's never gonna hurt to double check things again. The cam sensor. This thing people do mess up a lot. The convenient thing about these timing marks and knowing that you're at top dead center, cylinder four on the compression stroke, is that's where all these marks line up perfectly. You can see on the outside of the cam sensor housing, there's a raised nub, and on the hex here that rotates, there's a hash mark. Those two will be lined up with each other as you slide this into the exhaust cam. I usually pull this last cam cap because this thing likes to rotate on you just for no reason. When you pull this last cam cap off, you're able to watch and know 100% sure that your hash mark stays lined up with the raised nub as you slide it into the cam. You can put a bolt in there, snug it in place, get your cam cap back on, and you're good to go. If you have any other questions while you're doing this, it's better safe than sorry. There's a lot of people in the Ecotec community that can help. If you want to shoot me an email, alan.m@zzperformance.com. Even when I'm off the clock, I check my email pretty often. I'll help you out the best I can. I can go over the video with you, give you some little tips and tricks. I just really wanted to show you guys that this is not as intimidating as it seems. It is something that can be screwed up easily, but that usually only happens when you're rushing yourself and not paying attention to what's going on.